Checker Camps, the history and the future. I'm Crystal Sanders, also called Bookworm. There are a few things you need to know about me. One of them is I very much like to color purple. I'm part of a member of the Hackerspace in Hackalot, and I'm currently standing across the road here at Tilde Village. And my very first hacker camp, and that was one I've enjoyed very much, was actually EMF. So I'm very grateful to be back here. And for the next year, I'm going to work a lot for the next Dutch hacker camp, which is called Y. And I'm also part of IFCAT, so part of the foundation that organized that. One of the cool things is that this talk, or at least a version of it, is also simultaneously given at another conference. In Eindhoven, there's an open source conference called TIDOS. And my counterpart, Nancy, she's giving there the talk. So we're doing a simultaneous presentation of two people who co-chair this organization. I think this is very cool. So, the Dutch Hacker Camp have a rich history, and it all started with this small group of people who did techno-anarchism, and they had a small zine, and that zine published a lot of things like freaking things. They have diagrams of how you can hack some things. They have a political background. They have activism, and they bring out a small booklet every year, and they send of every few months, and they send it to all the people who are interested to that. And this is a basis for a lot of the things in the Netherlands which are hacker-based. So to start, this was the magazine. But some other things that came out of the hectic group of people was Wij Vertrouwen de Stemcomputers Niet, which was an activism started by Ron de Grondgrijp about why we in the Netherlands should not trust voting computers. And nowadays we still don't use voting computers, at least at the, you know, the normal voter level. Because of this. So this is one of the things that Dutch hacktivism did do. Another thing that came out of it, which is unfortunately not among us anymore, was one of the big Dutch internet providers. They were very early, and they decided that they needed to be better. And then they started their own internet provider, and that was called Access for All. Access for All had a rich history in its own. You can give a full talk on that. I'm not going to do that. But nowadays they're called Freedom Internet, or at least the spiritual people who do it nowadays. Successor, thank you. I'm very good at English. You will notice. And in one of the Hectic magazines, they decided from there were some people from the Hectic family. I believe Patricia and Ron, who went to the CCC Congress in what is every year between Christmas and New Year. And when they were there and they were going back, they were philosophizing from, we should have something like this in the Netherlands. So, a year later, there was this invitation in the mail. In the Hectic magazine, they said from, hey, we're going to Paradiso, we're going to have a conference there, it's going to be a big party, with a conference about all the topics that's currently in the Netherlands. So they had a full conference. I'm not going to notice and not going to highlight everything of them, but I'm going to highlight from all the Dutch conferences one or two things. And because this is a pretty brief talk, I have half an hour. But they did it in Paradiso. It was not yet a camping event, but it was 3 days in a big, in a big room, conference room thingy in the Netherlands. And they have there a good party, and a lot of things came out of that. So, it was a Galactic Hacker Party. And at the same time, at the same location, there was the conference. That was the ICATA, the International Conference for Alternative Use of Technology in Amsterdam. And the public there was already very much diverse. There were people from Hectic, of course, which are Dutch. There were people from CCC there, and there were people from the 2600 magazine. And a lot of people who via heard about it. And one of the cool things was, in this very early stage, this was 1989, I was at that moment 1.5 years old, There were a lot of people there from all over the world, and those who couldn't get there, there were cheap phone lines, so you can still get connected. So this was one of the earliest conferences, and there was already wide connectivity on all the over all of the world, and this was, I think, really amazing. One of the sponsors was called Antenna, and they had this small thing they wanted to promote called email, which is nowadays pretty much integrated all the way. But then, after this conference, 4 years later, they tasted for more. So, 4 years later, there was, in the hacktech scene, there was an invitation from Hacking at the End of the Universe. You can find this, by the way, on the archived hacktech pages. You can read this, it's very interesting, but I wanted to highlight two things. One is that I wanted to spread as much as they can. So they decided to do viral marketing. And this was in 1992, so viral marketing was new. And they asked you to bring their friends, and just tell them to as many people as they can. And the other one was the kind of people they invited. They invited basically everybody who reads the zine. And that's where people like techno freaks from all over the planet. And that basically are we nowadays. They invited this kind of people, and what I find very interesting is that the invitation, the people, and the marketing has not changed that much, even though we are technological, so much more advanced right now. So it was very interesting for me to read this. And they did. They did the second conference, and this one was a camping conference. So they did go to Lelystad, to a field there. They made as much as they can, they built up infrastructure. They were already completely volunteer-driven, which is what we still do nowadays. And they also already imported some drinks. They didn't do Club Mate, but they got some Jolt Cola from America. Yes. And next to technological advanced things that were happening there and all kind of things, I want to highlight one project. There was a Stone Age computer. And that was somebody who made from rocks. This was Mathilde Meupet. And she made a computer out of rocks. The shift key was done by a tire you had to squeeze, and for the rest you have to push the rocks to get data in. And in a true hacker camp fashion, this computer that was brought as is was being internet connected within a day, and then we had a stone computer that was connected to the internet of that year. But that was this event. Then, 4 years later, we started a new tradition because this first hacker camp was on a nice field and they wanted to have another time there. So Ron Grongrijp, the person who was running at that moment, asked the people of the Lanzerbos if they could go there again. But the ANWB, who had that terrain, was very much like, yeah, the publicity was not entirely what we hoped, and it was a bit negative, so we're not going to do that again. We wish you very much luck with your conference. So they had to go to look for a new terrain, and that's a tradition that kept on very long. And luck as it be, they found a new terrain. They didn't go with the name Mostly Harmless, they went with the name HIP 89. And the backronym for that was Hacking in Progress, because hacking is always in progress. It was a 3-day conference in Almere, not that far from Lelystad. And nobody can agree how many people were there, so I just displayed the range. One of the things was that the police was kind of iffy about what is happening there, and they made from, if too many weird things happen, we will cut the internet connection. People were warned for that, and of course, it was not needed, because people behaved, at least to the outside of the field. On the inside of the field, there was a connection, there was a network, but, you know, giving out IP addresses is something that we nowadays do automatically, but it was still a bit iffy at that days. So they made something for that. It's DHCP. It's something that the year later was recognized as a RFC number. So we can know it. It's been used for hackerspaces for some time. But it originated here. And that's cool. And that's what it is. Hackers events like this have the tendency to bring out things that will last for a while. But then it was time for another 4 years. And Dutch hacker camps are every 4 years. So 4 years later, we're in the year 2001. 2001 has something in the pop culture that we all know, at least at that time. So I decided to call it HAL 2001, because what else are you going to call it? They got a nice background name for it, Hackers at Large. And they got a new place to go. It was Enschede, and in Enschede they have it on the university building. There were a lot of people there, around 2,900. And of course in the logo they had to add the monolith there on the screen. And the monolith from 21 Space Odyssey. So, that was another event, and one of the nice things about this event is that it's the earliest one that I can still get recording from the CCC page. So the CCC do record all the talks that are happening here too. I'm very grateful for that. It means that I can look them even if I do one of the other 1,000 things that are happening. And the one from HAL are still there. You can see them now, you can go there now and just watch them back. Which is really cool. This is an index place where you can find them. So, but then we go to the next camp. It's 4 years later. And we currently have, in that time, we have a new foundation, how we'll work for it. And we have in the year 2005. This one is called What the Heck. A really good name, I think. So What the Heck 2005 was in Liemden, which is a bit farther away from all the other ones, but close to my home. I'm very sad I missed this one. And there were even more visitors here. And one of the things was that the local police was a bit not that confident about the amount of hackers that came there. So they asked if they can be there with a truck to keep, you know, a bit of an eye of the hackers. And they said, okay. And some of the hackers say, okay, if you keep an eye on us, then we keep an eye on you. And for the rest, it was a really cool camp. One of the other things that happened there first, in What the Heck, is the first known, at least according to Wikipedia. I didn't fact check it with everyone that I could find, but the people that I could agree. It's the first appearance of a data glow in the Netherlands. It was not the first time it was used. That honor goes to the CCC camp. But here you can see a data glow in this natural environment with all the cables coming out to the tent and just making a good connection with its environment. Really cool. But then we go again 4 years later. And then we're in the year 2009. And there we got HAR. HAR was called Hacking at Random. It was in Vierhouten. And I think personally this has one of the nicest logos. It looks like a field, it's technological, and it's organic. It's really cool. It also had plastic coins. And 2009 is about the year that 3D printers start to make an appearance. So there were a sale of coins, because of course you're going to have coins. And the coins look single color, simple and round. Dus of course they were being printed on the field. Yeah, that happens. That's stuff you have to deal with. There was also another talk there. There was a talk brought about a few American hackers who were on a plane, called Hackers on a Plane. And they went to Germany the year before, and they found out that hackerspaces existed. And they brought that to America. And in America, they tried that out, and they found that was a good idea. So for this event, they came back. And they gave a talk, and a lot of people were like, yes, this sounds like a good idea. And those people came together, and they had some more talks, and they gathered, and they put some money together. And that is how the hackerspaces came to be in the Netherlands. There were, of course, already collective labs before that. LAC, ASCII, PUSCII are the things I think about. But they were very much in the squatter tradition, where hackerspaces are a bit more stable, they have a place that they pay for, they are, you know, they can work a bit more in the future. So in that year, 2009, the first three hackerspaces in the Netherlands were started, which were Random Data, Hack42 and RESPACE. And they still exist. They're still going strong. And they are joined with a lot of more hackerspaces. And my personal favorite hackerspace is this one. It's HackLab in Eindhoven. You might notice there are some people from HackLab here. It's a relatively new one. It started after SHA 2017, and I love it. Most hackerspaces in the Netherlands are pretty open to visitors. So if you are at any chance at the Netherlands, just shoot a message to the local hackerspace, and they probably can give you a tour or something. Feel free to do that. They really like it. But in the meantime, the hackerspaces or the hacker events still start to continue. And we're in the year 2013. And in that year, OHM 2013 started. The acronym is Observe, Hack and Make. And that actually is what we do at events like this. It was for a 5-day event. And it was also the first one that is done by IFCAT. And IFCAT is the foundation that nowadays still makes sure these events happen. OHM 2013 is also the first event where something else first appeared that you might have seen today, which are the OHM lights. The OHM lights were made at BitLair, which was my first hackerspace. And there they made very nice environmental lighting that afterwards got used by event infra, and nowadays you can see them on top of the datenclose to see if the datenclose is still working. Then, the next camp is again 4 years later. And well, we're so much farther, and you know, we're having this much history, but again, we're still hacking anyways. This was in 2017. We had more visitors again, and it was the first Dutch hacker camp with an official badge. Badges introduce a lot of work, also up front. Here you see myself in that year doing one of the sweatshops, making sure the badge of that year was there. I like that badge, it's still very much in use at various places, and it's really cool. Another thing, at all those hacker camps, we try to repair the image of hackers. You know, hackers are good people, do good most of the time, and do good things for the community, for the world, for the security. You know, we'd like to make the world better, prettier, or more secure. So, this year in Zeewolde, in 2017, the local fire department trusted us enough to drive their brand new fire truck to the field, put it open, let people connect to it, and see how secure the new fire truck was. Some vulnerabilities were found pretty fast. Still, you needed to connect to the fire truck, so we can talk about how dangerous it is, but it's really cool. We are coming so far. They trust us. They come to the field with something to hack. They really participate. Of course, we're still. This was really cool that they do this. And also, the municipality was really happy with us having us there, because for an event, you know, we are pretty well behaved. We're not that noisy most of the time, and we're doing nice things. We have good documentation and everything. So the next year, we may come. So 4 years later, well, we were again welcome in Zeewolde. Except there was something. But the year 2021, there was not much happening then. So MCH 2021 did not occur, but a lot of preparation did happen. And we decided to see if it's viable to do this in 2022. And it was. It was amazing. A lot of people of us tried very hard to see to work. It was hard work, but we did. Just like EMF did in those years. It's very amazing the amount of work we do and what we can do. I'm so proud of this community. And it was a very good year. It was also very hot. We got 40 degrees one day. So we had to give some more water out. But we have a lot of cool tools which you could, you know, lift some cars, so don't leave your car at the field, because the Manitou is stronger. There were artworks there, and we had a very nice gate, and of course the tradition of more and more A4s with text appearing during the event. But that's the history. If you count up, we had to decide, are we going to shift the four-year schedule? Now we have to shift it 1 year. Or going to do the scary thing and do the whole organizing thing in 3 years? Well, in Europe, there's this nice schedule where you go to CCC camp every 4 years. You go to the Dutch hacker camp every 4 years in between. And the years in between, there's EMF. So shifting it a year was not really a goal. So the next Dutch hacker event will take place next year, in 2025. And it's going to call Y. And it's called Why, because we are all hackers, and hackers want some things. We try to improve the world. We yearn to make something better. So, I want to invite you all to the next Dutch Hacker Camp, which will take place the 8th of August till the 12th of August. You will have 5 years, and we will go to Geestemar Ambacht. Yes, that's the same municipality as that it was for Ohm. It's not the same terrain. It's next to it. We are aiming for around 3,500 visitors, and you are very welcome to be there. I don't yet have a house style, so for now there's this sticker. And I'm also, like half a day after we chosen the name, some very nice British people told me that you don't yearn for you yearn for something. So we put that between brackets. So, it will be this terrain. This terrain is very flat. It's hopefully not wet. But there are some ditches, there is some water. And I think it's a terrain where we can do very cool things. This is from the event that takes place there currently. Liquidity, I'm catching over that one. So it shows it at least can be a very cool terrain. It's also made to be a festival terrain, so that has some advantages. It has some facilities. It doesn't have some of the other facilities, so it will be all new kind of interesting challenges. But that's what we do, right? We fix challenges. And that's one of the things. We like to fix challenges, but events like EMF, events like the Dutch Hacker Camps, don't do themselves. They are really community-based. People who are like us, building events for like us. And that's what it is. We need people who are there who will build it. We need people who are early and trying to make things happen. And that's amazing. People come together, and that's for EMF and the Dutch Hacker Camps. But we need them. We're all volunteers. It's a lot of fun. You meet so many people when you organize. It's an opportunity to grow. It's an opportunity to try things you have never done or to get better in things you think you have not done yet enough. And the Dutch, the organization for Y2025 currently has around 42 teams. We did not guide for that, but we just came out of 42. Some teams need a lot of experience. Most of them don't. So feel free to do something you have never done before. Some of teams require you to be local, but most of them don't. You need to be on the field. And the organization up front, it's done online. So if you are interested, you are more than welcome to try and help. Because we really can make experiences like this happen, and it's really cool. And if you think, okay, the Netherlands is too far, I'm not going to go there, I'm pretty sure EMF can use those people too. So if you're seeing this and you think, yes, I want to do something, volunteer for your local events. It's so much fun. I can, with my whole heart, recommend it. If you want to do something, you can mail me. My email address is there. Or just contact the team that you're interested in directly. If you want to stay up to date, there's a mailing list. I know it's old tech, but it works. It's like the only tech that works for everyone. There's also a wiki. The wiki has all the information, there's all the teams. It's like the single source of truth, mostly. And we have a Mastodon account, all shown here. We also have all the other socials, but who cares about those? Mastodon is open. So, I hope to see you there. It will be in Geestemar-Ambacht. It will be in August 2025. And I want to close with, there's also a field day coming up. If you want to help out and are scared to mail me, this is the place where you can visit, see the terrain, try some things out, talk to people. It's an amazing opportunity. And lastly, yes, I mean you. As they did at Hectic, when they've invited for the first hacker event. It's all people who are a bit technically interested, who are curious, who want to make nice things. You're more than welcome. And let's spread it as a virus, as we've done all those times. Tell your friends, and find something. Find people who are interested and should experience this, and tell them about it. Thank you, and I hope to see you all.